Yo, what's up with y'all? It's Key Major, and I'm back with another video on the DK channel. Today, I'm showing you guys how to make some unique dark melodies for a producer's Southside. So, let's get straight to the video. So, this is how the sample sounds. That's how the sample sounds, so we'll get straight to the video. First thing I did coming up with the sample was I pulled in this one shot, sounds like this. And I came up with this melody. So we're starting at 151 BPM, and the first thing I did when I made this melody was I went to the piano roll options, I went to view, and I went to scale highlighting, and I right clicked on minor natural Aeolian, and then my root note, which was C. And now as you can see, the notes in the background are dark and then some are light gray. You just want to follow the ones that are light gray and you'll be in key, you'll be in the scale. So coming with this melody, that's exactly what I did. I just laid down my root note, which was C, and I just followed the notes that were in the light gray. I came up with this tiny pattern here. As you can see, it just copies over and over. There's a couple changes, but the first thing I did coming up with this melody was I came up with these two chords, C, G sharp, and then D sharp, C, G, and then D. As you see, those chords already sound real dark, but the next thing I did to just make it more unique was I messed around with the placement of the notes. For example, the G sharp, I moved it from here to here just to give the melody more bounce and make it more unique instead of, you know, just playing the same chords throughout the whole melody. After that, I just copied this little pattern over, and then I just created another top melody up here. Like I said earlier, I really just followed the light gray notes and just played whatever sounded in my head. I did add these top notes right here to just add more variety to the sample instead of these notes just playing like this. I did add these top notes, and I also did Alt S to strum them. I messed with the strength knob. The next thing I did after that was I took the exact same pattern and I just copied it over. All I did differently was I removed the F, and then that was really it. I just copied it over and over and over for this whole 9 bars right here. The next thing I did was I just copied the same melody over. I just removed a couple notes just to make it more simple and just make it sound less complex. When you're making these type of dark samples and melodies, you want to keep it really, really simple and really, really repetitive. You don't want to go crazy. Same pattern replays throughout the entire melody, you know what I'm saying? So it's just real simple and real, real repetitive. The next thing I did after that was I did Alt R, and I just messed up a lot with the velocity to play with the volume of the notes. So not all notes are hitting at the same volume. Some are, you know, dipping down and some are louder than others. And then I also panned it. It's just panning left and right. This is just giving the melody to sound more stereo. For the effects, the first thing I added was halftime. I went to 1 bar and I just turned the mix knob down to 43. One trick you can do when making these samples and making these melodies is you want to keep it really simple, but to make them sound better, you layer your sounds and you just stack your sounds on top of each other for the sample to sound more full. You don't always have to add a bunch of sounds. You could also do it with effects. For example, when I added this halftime and I turned the mix knob down to 43, it's basically just stacking my sounds, and it adds another layer to the sample where it's basically the same melody, the same sound, it's just halftime. So this is how it sounds without the halftime. So as you can see, when I enable the halftime, it sounds so much more full and it's covering more of the lower frequencies, and I'm still using the same sound. It's just I added an effect. So you could always do this trick whenever you want to make your sample sound more full and just better in general. After that, I added a flanger and a flangus, if I'm pronouncing that right. I just loaded up the flanger and I went to the default setting, and all I did was I turned down the mix knob. And for the flangus, I went to the presets and I went to fast flanger. I also turned down the mix knob for this one as well. I added these two effects just for the melody to sound less dry. The flanger and the flangus kind of give it reverb, and they kind of act similar to adding a chorus. They also play with the pan. I think the flanger moves the pan left and right, and they just both sound like reverb and chorus. After that, I added ambience, reverb, and then I just turned the mix knob down, and then I added a fruity stereo enhancer just to make it more stereo and cover more of the headphones. And then last, I just EQ'd a lot of the lows, a little bit of the mids, and I raised the highs a little bit. And lastly, down here, I did a little bit more stereo separation, and I just panned it to the left to cover the left side of the headphones. The next thing I did was I loaded up another one shot. And I basically just copied the exact same melody over, same notes, same everything, and I put it in the same mixer track. All I added differently was effect tricks. I used the preset Backwards Vocals. It's very, very famous preset used by Southside. And a bunch of people, really, everyone really uses this preset. It basically reverses the melody, and then it also adds like a delay. Sounds like this. So as you can see, that sounds really dope. It's just another one shot, the same notes, the same effects, everything's the same, not overcomplicating it. I just added an effect tricks just to sound more unique. With this one, I did export it and I put it in its own mixer track. I added a little bit more reverb and I panned it to the right and a little bit more stereo separation. For the first half, it's basically the same sample, everything's the same, but in the second half, I duplicated it and I just reversed it, so it sounds like this. So overall, this part is the same sample. I just chopped it up a little bit and then I took the same thing, duplicated it, and I just reversed it. So just for the sample to have more variety and not be the same sound playing over and over. This is another trick you could do to make your samples just sound more unique and different. Instead of adding a bunch of different sounds, you can take the same sound and just tweak it. For example, pitching it up or pitching it down, reversing like I did here. There's a lot of different things you could do instead of just adding a bunch of sounds and overcomplicating it. The last thing I did for the melody was I added Contact Spitfire solo violin. This is a really nice solo violin. With this violin, I came up with this pattern right here. When coming up with this pattern, it was extremely easy. All I did was, if you take this melody and go back to the original melody, as you can see, I basically used like the same notes and the same top melody. It's just some notes are playing at different times and I'm using a little bit of different notes and I just copied it over and raised it an octave. So yeah, for this melody, all I did differently was I just copied this simple pattern over to here and I just added a G at the end to just give more variety. One thing I did do differently with this violin is instead of all the notes playing and gliding together like this, I shortened some of the notes to sound staccato, and some of the notes are still long and gliding, but I shortened most of the notes so they could sound staccato and sound like this. And the last thing I did was I held control and left click and dragged over the notes, and then I did control B, and then I just raised it an octave by doing control and then up on the arrow. The effects on the violin, I did a little bit of stereo separation again, and all I did was I added reverb, I just turned the mixing up down, and then I took out all the lows, and that was really it for the violin. But yeah, the last thing I did was I just went to the master, like all my other samples, I added an EQ, I turned down the lows, a little bit of the mids, and I raised the highs a little bit, and I just raised the volume in general, and I exported it, and I didn't pitch it down or up, I just left it like that, and this is how the final sample sounds. So that was it for the video. I really hope you guys did enjoy and learn something new. If you did enjoy it, make sure to leave a like and you comment other ideas or what you learned in the comment section below. Make sure you guys subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified when we drop our new tutorials and our loop kits every Friday. And last thing, make sure you guys sign up for our Patreon down below. It's a $10 monthly subscription and you get taught by any of the DK members how to make beats, samples, mix your beats, arrange your beats, whatever it is, we're here to teach you. And last thing is make sure you guys follow me on Instagram at KeyMajorBeats. I also post a lot of my other loop kits on there and some beat snippets. So make sure you go follow me over there. But other than that, man, that's really it. I really hope you guys did enjoy this video. And I'll see you guys in the next one.